Hi friends, in this video we shall discuss about thoracic outlet syndrome. Patient presents with complaint of paresthesia along the medial aspect of arm. Sudden flare up or aggravation of symptoms when arm is abducted above the head. That means when the hand is placed above the head or in complete range of abduction of the affected side, it causes sudden aggravation. On palpation, there is tenderness over supraclavicular fossa. And provisional diagnosis is cervical rip. Coming to thoracic outlet, please note, this is the potential space in between anterior and medial scalenus. And base of it is first rib. Through this potential space, subclavian artery and lower trunk of brachial plexus pass. Whenever there is occlusion to artery, then there will be obliteration to radial pulse. Whenever there is complete occlusion, then it causes gangrenous changes in the distal extremities. Whenever there is neurological occlusion, that means the lower trunk of brachial plexus is occluded, then it causes paresthesia and pain along the medial aspect or ulnar aspect of arm. In this X-ray, cervical spine AP view, you shall be able to see elongation of the seventh transverse process of cervical vertebra, and it causes occlusion to this particular area. Whenever it's bony, we shall be able to diagnose it in X-ray, but when it's fibrous, then we want to do clinical examination. This is the elongation of transverse process of seventh cervical vertebra, which causes occlusion to this particular area. Vascular occlusion is due to occlusion of subclavian artery, and it causes changes in the pulse. Neurological changes is facilitated when we shall able to diagnose it by the clinical presentation of paresthesia, same as that of lower cervical compression, but the clinical examination of lower cervical cord, that is spurling, will be negative in this particular case. And on palpation, we shall able to feel the tenderness over the supraclavicular fossa. It's aggravated by keeping the arm in abducted position, and it's relieved by changing position of the arm. Whenever it's chronic, it causes weakness of hand and fine movements are affected. And we shall able to see thenar and hypothenar wasting. Whenever there is complete occlusion of subclavian artery, then it causes gangrene, which is a surgical emergency. In that particular condition, we need surgical reference. Causes include cervical rib, abnormal scalene attachments, which should be diagnosed only in clinical examination, and Pancoast tumor, the tumor at the apex of lungs, which shall be seen in inspection. While we check both the supraclavicular fossa, whenever there is Pancoast tumor, we shall able to find a swelling in the supraclavicular fossa. Coming to the clinical examination of cervical rib, first one is Adson's test. In Adson's test, shoulder is abducted to 30 degree. Radial pulse is checked. Then ask the patient to rotate the cervical spine to the affected side. After 1 minute, keep the arm in normal position and ask the patient to look straight. Then again, check the pulse. Whenever there is change in pulse, we shall able to diagnose thoracic outlet syndrome or cervical rip and compare it with the normal side. Coming to the next clinical examination, Roos test. In this, shoulder is abducted to 90 degree and external rotation is done in 90 degree abduction. That position is called surrender position. Roos test is also called as elevated arm stress test. Shoulder is abducted to 90 degree. Then external rotation is done. Elbow is flexed to 90 degree. Then ask the patient to clench the fist slowly and gently, continuously for 3 minutes. In this video, you shall able to see Roos test, in which shoulder is abducted to 90 degree and external rotation of shoulder in 90 degree abduction is done. Elbow is flexed to 90 degree in this particular position, and this position is called as surrender position. in this particular position, ask the patient to clench the fist continuously for 3 minutes. Whenever there is neurovascular occlusion, patient is not able to continue this for 3 minutes. Thus, we shall able to diagnose. It's more confirmatory test. This Roche test is more confirmatory. Coming to next test, it's the right test. In Wright's test, both the shoulder is abducted to 180 degree and then radial pulse is checked and compared to normal side. This is Wright's test. And the last one is, final one is military posture test, in which shoulder is extended to 30 degree, both radial pulse is checked, cervical spine is in extension. In this particular position, cervical spine is in extension. I repeat, in military posture test, shoulder is extended to 30 degree, and in this particular position, both the radial pulse are checked and cervical spine is in extended position. In this particular position, this particular clinical examination is done, military posture. The affected side pulse will be less when compared to the normal side. I already explained that whenever there is vascular occlusion and it's complete, then it requires surgical management. In all other conditions, strengthening of muscles of that particular area, including upper trapezius, sternocleidomastoid, scalenus, then serratus anterior, rhomboids, levator scapula, pectoralis group, rotator cuff muscles, all these muscles require strengthening to avoid shoulder drooping. And if there is no complete vascular occlusion, then we shall able to manage this condition with proper rehabilitation and advise the patient the correct posture to be maintained to avoid recurrence. Rehabilitation includes self-resisted scapular elevation, shoulder stretch, scapular sitting, endurance training exercise for the shoulder girdle muscles, mainly pectoralis group and rotator cuff, progressive resistance exercise for shoulder girdle muscles with weight bearing shall be advised, and it is at the end of the rehab. It shall be advised at the end of the rehab. It should be started with self-resisted scapular elevation. Coming to cervical rib, please remember the clinical anatomy. The clinical examination tests include Adsens, Roos, Wright's, and military posture test. X-ray includes cervical spine AP view. If we are able to do the clinical examination and diagnose the case, then no need of MRI in this particular condition. If there is vascular occlusion, it requires surgical management. In all other conditions of thoracic outlet syndrome, we shall advise the patient posture correction and rehabilitation to better quality of life and to avoid recurrence. Thank you.